Hello guys, what's new today? Well, nothing new today. I have plenty other things to show you. But before we come there, I want to show you this ad I saw today. And I saw here loudspeakers. Yes, loudspeakers. Nice big loudspeakers you can connect. Well, very strange, you know. So the size is 33 by 33 by 101 centimeters. So pretty big speakers. And I saw the highest bid is 80 euro. So I think, let me open this picture. And then I saw speakers I never saw before. I mean, I could not read the brand. So this is for me new. I think, well, I don't know this logo. So I thought, okay, why not send this guy a message? And that's what I did. I sent him this message, and I asked him, I have interest in your speakers. Please, can you tell me which brand it is? And he say, BIC, so big. And I already have a bid from 250 euro. So I thought, okay, you know, because when I read this ad, I saw the highest bid is 80 euro. And, well, they look nice, they look old. And I thought, well, if I can have them for 100, 125 euro, you know, maybe if I don't like the sound and I resell the speakers, maybe I can have my money back, or, you know, because Huizen, the place here, Huizen, it is 100 kilometers from my house, you know, so, and I don't like to drive this far for things I don't know what it is, you know, but I'm going to buy, and I really don't know what these speakers are. So I went on the internet with this guy's information that the speakers are big, and I found these pictures. I see, okay, this is how it is looking. It is, so this is of course the woofer chassis, yeah, because as you can see over here, the woofer is pointed downwards. It's a 12-inch woofer, and here you have the mid-tone and the tweeter, and it is omni-directional. That means that the sound from the mid, the treble, and the woofer, they go all directions. And I thought, okay, they're looking fantastic. Fantastic looking speakers, you know. And I saw also these pictures. This is a good looking one, a much better looking one. Beautiful speakers, my friends. I never saw this thing in my life before, be honest. What's this, 12-inch woofer? This is, I'm not sure what this thing is, maybe to make the woofer sound better. From here you have the mids, and here you have the treble. Beautiful speaker, soundspan system by BIC, B-E-C. And I remember BIC, B-E-C, they made those pens you can write with, you know, very famous brand, BIC. But I never knew, and I'm also not sure if it is the same company who make these pens, also make these speakers, but yeah, I never heard. Well, this is the backside, made in the USA, United States of America, New York, Westbury Road, yeah, BIC FNET, Division of FNET Incorporation. The impedance is 6 to 8 ohms, and the power is 130 watt undistorted. So, okay, this is what it is, and this is what they ask, one of them for sale at the moment on eBay, and they ask $600 for these speakers, and so the name of the speaker is BIC Soundspan TPR 6000. Omnidirectional three-way speakers with 12-inch woofer, yes. weight is 60 lbs, so 60 lbs not that very heavy for this big speakers. Manufactured in the 70's. Original MSRP is $900. So they were produced from 1979 to 84. Yeah. So, okay. But, okay. Then I thought, okay, 250 euro, you know. And this guy asks 600. But, you know, the Netherlands is a difficult market. And I thought, okay, let me see if there are other sellers, you know, because if it is a good sound, and the 250 euro is not expensive. So I went digging more, deeper, and I found this thing. One of my most favorite places I find, well, not always good info, but I can always find some info, you know, is Audio Karma. I say not good info because this guy, for example, you know, he is a subscriber and he say, my impression is that the sound spans, despite being pretty nice speakers, are not valuable. They are large and weird and light. And Big isn't exactly a hot company, all of which militate against high price used. But there are people out there who want Omnis, and they do have a large sound which is attractive to many people. So this guy say that they are not worth to buy, you know. And so I'm happy with Audio Karma. You can always read what other people experienced before they, well, I don't have experience with these speakers. So that's when I always try to fish out how these speakers are, you know. And here I say, Nat, thanks for the info. The box weight is 86 lbs each, but you're right, they are different looking. Anything on the spectrums, you know? And then this guy say, there's a parallel treat in AK, you know, blah, blah, blah. Okay, I went to this thing. Big sound span, tear down and mods, you know? And this guy bought, let me see, backstory. I was looking for a pair of vintage floor speakers when a friend of mine suggested that I should get this pair of Big Soundspan TPR 600. I was a bit skeptic at first, but it was not what I was looking for anyway. To make a long story short, I fell in love with the looks of them. And he handed them over for free, so so it was hard to resist. Of course, for free, everybody wants them for free. I immediately started to look for information about the speakers, but I found very little online. So I thought it would be a good idea to start this street to gather some information and also to ask for some advice regarding possible mods. My friend bought these speakers new in 1979 and has been the only owner. The condition is near mint, so I'm a bit hesitant to mod them, but all depends on your feedback, I guess. I guess you all know what they look like, big bulky box with a chocolate fountain on top, somewhat hidden under big boxy speaker grills. Attached is a picture for the ones not knowing what I'm talking about. Stay tuned. And okay, this guy, right, I will place the link from this Audio Karma thread in the comments below. And this guy is, well, he is, let me see, well, the tweeters were not the same, so probably one time the tweeter was already changed or broken. Anyway, that's picture of the wire, internals of the box, crossover, how do they sound? Okay, this is important. You might want to know how they sound. Let me say this, they look more impressive than they sound. But I love the look. They fit right in with the style of our home. Okay, well guys, I admit, last week, I had some very cheap speakers in my house. You will see that video soon. the name of these speakers is, let me remember, Phonars 400s, and they were not my speakers. I bought these speakers for Simon, because Simon lived too far away to pick these speakers up, and this guy is 18 years old, he don't have a car, not yet. Yeah, he's a student, this guy. And I picked these speakers up together with this Onkyo shirt, and they were already 2 months in my house, upstairs. And then the day came when he picked these speakers up, and that was last Saturday, and he picked these speakers up. And I said, okay, let me make a video from the speaker test video, you know, VS test against my Cantons. You know, and I'm talking about Phonars, yes, 400, let me remember the name. Well, I forgot the complete name. You will see it soon in my video. And I thought nothing much about these speakers. You know, I thought, well, they were lightweighted and with a woofer, just a three-way system. You will see this video, these speakers. And the surprising thing, I don't like these speakers, the looks at all, you know. And the remarkable thing was that these speakers sounded better than my Cantons. Yeah, my friends. And if I would give him 100 euro, I'm sure he would sell them for me for 100 euro, maybe even cheaper, you know, because if you place these speakers online, I paid for the complete setup, because I bought them for him 50 euro. This is what I bought for the speakers and the four Onkyo amplifier, CD player and cassette deck, I think, I forgot. I paid for the complete set, you know, all the Onkyo pieces were in box. And the complete set, I paid 50 euro. And I'm sure if you place these speakers on Marktplaats in the Netherlands, so second hand, you won't get more as 50 euro second hand, because nobody knows this brand, you know. And what I see in Germany, they sell some Phonars, and they don't get so many reactions, and 50 euro is really the max. So if I would give him this 50 or 75 euro, I'm sure he would have sold them to me for 75 euro. But these speakers sounded better as my Cantons, so I was surprised. Only in the low end, of course, my Cantons win from these Phonars, but that's normal. My Cantons have two big woofers and it goes very low. But in the mid and in the treble, they lost. My speakers lost. So I was very surprised. And I asked him, do you hear the same thing as I do? He was also convinced that these speakers sounded better than my Cantons. So, and then you would ask with yourself, so why you don't bought these speakers? So when I would have bought these speakers, I would have bought them to resell them, because I also already made my video, you know, and I don't want to keep these speakers because I think they were ugly, you know, not ugly, but I prefer my big looking Cantons. And well, so you see, my friends, there are miracles are always there, because I thought, well, below 200 euro, it's difficult, very difficult to find good sounding speakers. But these Phonars, if you can find them, not sure if they was best sold in America. I think it was a small speaker company. They still sell so Phonars today, but they are very expensive. They are floor standards, not as these speakers, but more bigger, and they are expensive speakers, 3 to 4,000 euro each, expensive speakers. But these speakers I'm talking now, the Canton Silver 400, well, they were cheap speakers from the 1988, and the mids are fantastic, the highs are fantastic. The woofer goes deep, but not as deep as my Cantons. Beautiful sound, my friends. And that's why I like this hobby. You still, you know, I expected really nothing from these speakers, and they are now playing in his parents' living room. So they found a good place. I don't think he will sell these speakers, not sure, but they are playing now in his parents' living room. And that's why I'm telling you, well, there are some nice cheap speakers around, my friends. Anyway, this video will come soon. We talk about these speakers now, and he say, sounds grow, how do they sound? Yes, don't get me wrong, these speakers sometimes sounds really great, but sometimes lack the edge. It all depends on what's driving them, the source and type of music. My friend had them paired with the Soundspan 70 original. Yes, I got the constraint where they are placed right now in our living room. The way WAF dictate the maximum depth of 37 centimeters for the amplifier. This made me first pair them up with a Rotor RA931 MK2, but that didn't work out at all. Sound was too thin and I almost gave up on them, especially after pairing them with a much more powerful Harman Kardon, same weak sound. I happen to have a Sony TAF220, and this is a cheap amplifier, my friends. The TAF2020 is nothing much special, and that I started to renovate in the lack of something else to do. I didn't expect much, but I hooked it up to these speakers, and it is actually what has sounded the best so far. And a bit of a surprise, of course, because this is a cheap amplifier. I currently got them hooked up to a Technics SUV 570 PXS cap, and it works okay, but I got my eyes on a Sony TA550AS. I hope it will be a good pairing based on my experience with the cheap TAF220. Okay, and then this guy, installation instruction manual, you know, you can download it here as a PDF file. And way forward, you know, he's talking about these speakers, crossover and binding posts, fast lining and new cables. So he changed the cables, yeah, he recapped them. And finally, after recapping and recabling it, the warm and firstly feeling when everything is back together and you can enjoy your hard work. These speakers should now be at least as good as new and hopefully last another 70 years or 37 years to come. And how do they sound after the mods? Don't expect earth-shattering changes. Sounding like a new set of speaker or anything like that. It will defy the laws of physics. The change in sound quality is, however, notable, verified by my wife, the former musician with much better ears than me. Especially tremble benefits from these mods. I can now, for example, hear every detail in high, head, and cymbals. Well worth the job. Only one mod left, reconstruct the foam covering the woofers around the base of the chocolate fountain. Attach our images, okay, not interesting, but, you know. And then, let me see. Speaker foam, let me see, what is he writing about the sound? Anyway, in the end, you know, this guy wasn't happy with the sound, you know, and so I think, you know, the guy asked me €250, or not he asked me, but he already have a bid from €250, and I think, you know, for the looks, watch this. These are just impressive speakers, my friends. I mean, look at this, you know, because the linen is shining through. You can see what is happening inside the speaker, you know. So if you're sitting on a distance from 3-4 meters, you see what is happening inside. Well, happening what is inside this speaker, you know, this this square. You can see what is inside, and that's nice, you know. And it's a beautiful speaker, beautiful, you know, but yeah, you know, my speakers lost from those cheap but ugly, or ugly, not ugly, but you know, nothing special speakers I just told you about, those Walnuts, you know. But I don't want to lose my beautiful speakers, and I have to be honest, you know, if I was a real audiophile, who would have changed his speakers immediately for those Walnuts. And I'm not ashamed to tell you that I'm not a real audiophile. I also go for the look sometimes, you know. And I know that's stupid, so that's why I don't count myself as an audiophile. And well, anyway, these speakers lost anyway. They were not 100% better in the bars. My Canton still wins. You know, you will see this video soon. But I was surprised from these Walnuts that they sound so terrific, you know. Anyway, these speakers, I don't think they sound good, you know. Especially what I read on Audio Karma, what this guy is telling. And so that's why, if I could buy them for 100, 125, I would bought them. Test them out for you. Because this is the stuff you want to see in my channel. The rare stuff, you know, you would never buy or never see. When can you find a pair from these big speakers? Never. They are rare. So that's why I was interested. I said, wow, what kind of speakers are these, you know? But yeah, he already have a bid from 250. I'm not sure if he's telling the truth. Some of these guys are lying, you know, but yeah. That means that I have to offer him 260, 275 to get the speakers. And it is 1 hour driving, 2 hours driving, 1 hour back and forth, 2 hours. So that's another 40, 50, no, well, 40 euro gasoline. So that comes with 260, comes on 300 euro, you know, for these speakers, bad sounding speakers, 300 euro. Well, I think so. And then I have to, after the video, I have to resell them again. And, you know, I don't mind to lose 50 euro. You know, I often lose 50 or 100 euro on things I buy. I don't mind. I have my video. My video is more important than the stuff, you know. But, you know, and I'm not sure if I can resell them for even 150, you know. So I'm losing 150 euro. No, this if I was sure I could have my money back, you know, or even lose 50 euro, you know, I would have bought them. But guys, you have to understand, I cannot buy everything to make videos. So that's why I just show you these speakers without testing them today, you know. And I can buy them. I the offer is still there, you know. I have a bid from 250. If I bid 260, I'm sure he will sell them. Maybe 275. Not sure what he wants, but you know. Then I lose again 50 euro. You know, and this the video I will make from this. I will be honest to you. A good video, you know. When I have a very good video, you know. It brings me in the first week, it brings me about 30 US dollar. This is what I earn on YouTube. But sometimes the video is not that interesting. Sometimes I think, wow, it's a very interesting thing to see, but it's not very interesting. And the video only brings me 5 US dollar in the first week. And after that first week, nobody watched this video anymore. And I earn pennies, you know. It's only the first week when everybody want to see what is this new video from me. They hook in and they watch this video, and then it is popular, you know, for a week, and then it makes some popular videos can make 20, 30, 40 US dollar in a week. I admit that, you know, but only a few, you know. Most videos never comes above $10. So if I lose €50 with this with this speakers, I would never get that back with my video count, with the money I earn on YouTube with this video, you know, because I tell you, well, all my videos make maybe, you know, $10 a video. You know, the middle price my a video make for me is not even 10, 8 at the moment, $8 a year. You know, that's what every video make in a year, $8, you know. And to lose €50, and I think when I buy these things for 275, well, let's say 260 with the 40 gasoline is 300. I don't think I can resell them for €150. I think this guy is lying. €250, you have a bid from €250, that's a lot of money, you know. That's a lot of money. Let me see the ad one more time. That's a lot of money. But I thought it was interesting because I saw a bid from €80. And he have his phone number over here. And I saw a bid from 80. So I think, well, if I can buy that for 100, then they are interesting for me, you know. I mean, they're still good looking. Then I can resell them, you know. 100 plus €40 gasoline is 140. I can resell them for the same money. I don't lose my money. I have my video, you know. What's for me important, most important thing, and I can resell them for the same price, maybe a little bit profit, you know. Even if I could buy them for 150, I think I would go for it. But not for 260, my friends. That's why this video will be only the pictures. But I'm sure you also never saw these speakers before in your life, and that's why I made this video. They are. Amazing speakers, my friends, and well, amazing in the sense, maybe not amazing sounding, but amazing in the looks. Because what's this? This is how they are looking without the casing. This is so special. But yeah, if the sound is not special, why would you buy these speakers for the looks? No. Never buy speakers for the looks. Well, if they sound pretty nice, you can buy them, you know. I also just admit that I kept my Cantons for the better sounding Phonards, you know. And because I like the looks of those impressive Cantons. But yeah, anyway, I will sell these Cantons anyway, you know. I know I will sell them in a... Maybe in a year, maybe in 2 years, maybe in 2 years. I will sell them anyway, you know. But I like the look, so they stay. I will sell them. And I know what kind of speakers I want. Still waiting for a good price, you know. So and I think that's the reason. Because I already know what speakers will replace these. But not the Phonards. No, the Phonards are ugly speakers. But you will see in the movie, in the video, what I mean. Anyway, these speakers stay where they are. And if you ever see these speakers, if you have the opportunity to buy these speakers, I would not advise. If you know, if the price is €100, $100, of course, go for them, you know. That's what I would have done if I could get it for 100, 125, not for 250, €300, you know. Look, what's this? This is in UK, United Kingdom audio market, and... this guy asked $300, you know, $300. And well, what are these guys asking for these speakers? $600, you know. What is this guy asking? $275, but sold. And this guy is asking. Well, I think this is just a review page, yeah. US audio market, well, okay. Well, guys, thanks for watching this video from the Soundspan, the big Soundspan TPR 600. Hope you like this video. You know, don't be angry. I didn't do a real review. You know, I can't. I just explain. I cannot buy everything. You know, I cannot review everything. But I thought, okay, this thing is special enough to make a video of it. Never saw it before, and I'm sure many of you also see this speaker for the first time. Thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up if you like this video. And for now, I say ciao, ciao.